I'm going to make a kitchen island out of this 1968 media cabinet. It's got some wonderful slide outs, and it will be perfect for my friend who needs it for her cosmetic business. And our budget is $100 for the entire project. This was the starting point at $40. My client wants this unit to be at comfortable bar top height. And so the first thing I needed to do was work on the actual height of it. And she's, let's say, on the more vertically challenged side. And so we didn't need it to be more than about 38 inches. So the first thing I did was take off the cabinet doors, took out anything that was loose, and then I cut some wood, and it's two different layers of wood that you see right there, and got them up to the height that I wanted, including these new wheels. I actually broke one of the old wheels, which was not the greatest wheel in the first place. And these are pretty sassy because they're this red that my friend likes so much. So the next thing will be to camouflage this. So my plan for this cabinet was to give it a shiplap look on the back. And of course, we're on a tight budget. And so a really good way to do that is by cutting strips out of quarter inch material. So this is underlayment for floors, and it can be for the back of cabinets as well. Some people call it luan, and what I did was just cut it into strips on the table saw. And the best idea is to glue it and to use the nail gun. So I have some liquid nails in my caulk gun, and I'll just squirt it out here, be sure it's all the way down. And I squirt it on here. And then I'm gonna take the pressure off the gun so it doesn't leak as much as it would if you left the pressure on. So then I line it up with my edges. And when you're doing this sort of look, it's okay if you have a little bit of a gap, because real shiplap has some sort of a gap. You know, it's not perfect. In fact, this is a whole lot more perfect than normal shiplap is. So then I'm just going to tack it in the solid pieces, which I have solid on the edges, and then there's a strip in the middle. And then ideally, step after gluing is to be sure that your piece is weighted down, because any place that you don't have a nail, especially if it's a large expanse, is going to buckle up. So I just found these projects of mine here that are already here in the garage, and have laid them on top so that it acts as that weight. And so I'll let these rest overnight, and hopefully everything will be nice and flat.
I'm doing my best to save cost, so I'm reusing as many things as I can and finding scraps in the garage. But I came to this corner where I've added the shiplap and decided I needed some trim here at the bottom. So I'm using a piece of scrap I had, reusing a piece of trim that I took off the top of this cabinet. And to make it all work, I'm putting a piece of wood right here. But that meant I had to trim off the trim that was already on there. So I use this tool, which is very handy. It's called an oscillating multi-tool, and I highly recommend it in anybody's toolbox, and it's only about $20 at Harbor Freight.
These edges actually had this lip sort of protruding. So since this is made out of particle board, it's not hard to chisel off, especially if you use the multi-tool that I already told you about. It makes really quick work of it. This is the progress so far today. I have put a half inch piece of nice sanded plywood on top, and then I've trimmed it out with 1x2 material, and I used the miter saw to cut that. And then down the sides, I also trimmed it out with 1x2, partly to make
the shiplap look nice and even, and also, as I showed you before, where the two kinds of trim come together, I needed there to be some sort of bridge. So now I'm actually working on the drop leaf section. I'm making a wood sandwich right now, and the reason is that the drop leaf, because of how I have to work it with hinges and things, I need it to be a bit thick, and I don't want the weight of something super thick. So I'm taking the same material as I used on the top, the half inch, and then I'm just filling it in with some other pieces that are all the same, and then I'm going to put a piece of Luon on top of that, which is the same stuff that I used to make the shiplap. So I'll just nail all that together. Now, one of the main reasons I have to have something solid is that I'm going to be putting hinges in here, and you can't do that in something really thin. And I'm also going to have corbels that are hinged, so that's the other reason why I have some blocking in here. One of the challenges I had was that in using up scrap wood, one of these pieces was super warped. And so to make it work, because I need it right along this edge and I need it straight, I just cut it into four sections, and so now I can use it and it has no bend in it, and it'll work out perfectly, and I've used up a piece of scrap I would not have been able to use otherwise. Okay, you were looking at the top of the bar and also the leaf that's going to fold down this way. And I had to notch out both of them, and the reason is that the hinge pin is takes up about this much space, and if I didn't notch it out, then I would have that big of a gap with the leaf in the up position, and I didn't want that. I wanted a really narrow gap. So that was a necessary evil, so I'll sand it down and, you know, it'll be fine. I needed some corbels for the drop leaf when it's in the up position, and I didn't have any more money to buy any. And they also need to be pretty big, which means you can really end up spending a lot of money on that kind of stuff. So I had some scrap wood left over from a desk project. This was from some other project I cut apart. And then this was some other scrap wood. And so I'm going to use my Craig jig and attach them all together and make two really nice big corbels for no money. Finished the corbels, they've had time to dry. I used the Craig jig to attach them together, and then put the plugs that come with the Craig jig in there, and that makes for a nice finish. Once it's painted out, it'll be great. And I've decided to, instead of attaching the corbels to the top here, I'm actually going to attach them to the back. And so I need to have two hinges right here, and the hinges need to be able to go into something strong so they don't just pull out of a thin backing. And even though I've got two layers of quarter inch material in here, I wanted a little more support. So I took some wood that was about the same thickness, so it's a one by material, and I put it inside the cabinet. So when I screw the hinges in, it's gonna be screwing into a lot of meat, and that should add the support that it needs to have. When I asked my friend that I'm doing this for, whether she wanted it to be just a clear coat on here or whether she wanted it to be stained the same dark as the inside of the cabinet, she said clear coat. But when I look at it, it's really, because this was all brand new wood, it's just a little too pristine, especially knowing that we're gonna be aging down the rest of the cabinet. It's going to be white, but we're gonna age it down. So this is actually something that I discovered on accident a few years ago. I've already put polyurethane on here. I've put two coats on, actually. I probably should have done this after the first coat, but I just decided to do it. I'm actually gonna come back and age this down and ding it up a little bit. And then I'm taking stain and I'm wiping it on and wiping it right off. And it's just soaking in just enough, because if I did this on the raw wood, it would turn the wood really dark, and I don't want it dark. I just want it aged a bit. And so it will settle into the crevices, excuse me, and any dings that I put in it, and that will give it that aged effect that I'm going for. This entertainment center originally came with these doors that had some leaded glass in them. And although it was beautiful, it really didn't suit this style that we're going for. And so when I floated the idea of chicken wire, my friend wasn't really that enthused. She was okay with it, but didn't really seem that enthused about it.
So I decided to do some punch tin, and this is a little surprise for her, so hopefully she likes it. So the first thing I did was take a measurement of this opening, and then I had some aluminum flashing on hand for other projects that I do. And so I cut the aluminum flashing, which you can actually just cut with scissors. You can get this at Home Depot or Lowe's, and it can come in like 24-inch widths or 12-inch widths. And so this will fit in that panel. And then she also had shown me sort of an inspiration piece that she had, which was a tray that was the image of Van Gogh, or Van Gogh, if you want to be really accurate, some of his irises. So I love irises, and I already had a drawing of an iris because of another project I had done. And so I traced the iris onto some clear contact paper, which I then attached onto the sheet metal. And then the next step after that, I did decide to simplify the design. It was a bit much. But then after that, I just took a nail punch, and this is the kind of punch you use to set nails that aren't all the way flush, and this will inset them so that you can cover them with spackle. We use nail guns now, so these aren't used a ton anymore, but you can call them a nail set as well. And you just put follow the lines that you want to follow and pound it, and you have your hole. Now, what is a really important detail is that you need to have some sort of semi-cushiony surface. So this is just a piece of foam core from Dollar Tree, and then I have it on top of my cutting mat. You could have it on top of another piece of wood. The fear is if you don't have something solid under it, then it can just go down and make a hole in your work surface, because it can punch right through the foam core. But if you don't have that cushion, then the hole won't have anywhere to go. So you have to have that, or it's not going to actually make a hole. So I will install these as soon as I get the rest of them punched out. To attach the punch tin, I first put a piece of mat board to line it, and then I use strapping for pipes. Now you can use other little tabs. I was going to use the ones that came with the cabinet, but they broke off, and this is what I had, so that's why I used it, but it's working out well. You can get it at Lowe's or Home Depot, and it comes in handy for other things as well. Took the place of the leaded glass that used to be here. And then
All the hardware was spray painted silver and then reused. And as time goes on, the gold will start to show through, and that will add a really cool vintage kind of vibe. And then I painted just the shelves, the dark red, and I just did sort of a dry brush thing. I didn't have that much paint, and I didn't want to spend a ton of time on the inside of the cabinet, and so I wanted to spend all my time on the outside. So just a little hint of the red, and it just adds a little sass to it that goes with the red wheels on the bottom, which I know you can't see. I did have to add some trim, and then on the back side, and then down here, we've got the faux shiplap. And then to make this, the full-size island turn into just sort of a countertop or a console, you just lift it slightly. Be sure you lift it all the way so that the corbels go in all the way. And then just drop it down. And it's a nice, slim, it's probably only about 18 inches this way. And so it fits against the wall nicely. And I think it'll work really well for Joni, and she'll be able to keep all of her cosmetic business stuff handy. And it's definitely worth a try. If you have a piece of furniture that you would like to get some advice on about how to upcycle or just to make it a better version of itself, then just reach out to me. You can email me, beth@carethouse.com, or go to our website, carethouse.com, or reach out by Chicks with Tools Facebook, Instagram. Any of those channels will work. So I hope that you keep trying to do stuff and making your homes a more beautiful place and blessing others with your abilities and your passions. Okay, this is my friend Joni that I made this for. And we are in her kitchen where this is going to go. She's painted the wall, which is fantastic. I wanted to show you that this is the iris to go with your irises.
Awesome.
And then one of the shelves slid down while we were driving. But
yeah.
It's painted red.
Okay. I like that.
Just like this, and it's just dry brushed. So
okay.
You know, it's no train smash if you want to dry brush over the top. So dry brush that part. Then I want to show you how the leaf works. Not the leaf, but
yes.
Close it 100%.